There should be no such negligences like this. Nothing uncertain should be pushed. Now, what other discrepancies there may be like this? Or what is the use of such editing? Everything must be done very carefully and attentively. So, here, next we have here, it's another letter to Ramananda, April 1970, regarding topmost yoga. This is one of the small books. In the blueprint, there are many mistakes. I'm pointing out some of them as follows. Page 2, decided to kill his sister, not sisters, because only Devaki was there. The last compromise was that he had Vasudev proposed to the brother-in-law. This sentence is obscure. The actual fact is Vasudev made a compromise and said to his brother-in-law such and such. Then everywhere there is yogins, goswamins, sannyasis in several many places. The end is not required. That I have already informed Pradyumna. Prabhupada changed that. In Prabhupada's book from India, he uses sannyasin and goswamin. But here around 69-70, he introduces a different standard. I think the more accepted standard was sannyasi, sis, goswamis, and so on. That you can see his. So one cannot even take Prabhupada's Bhagavatam from India and say, well, now we go just back to this. This is the standard. Because as Prabhupada, he introduced a little different standard in Sanskrit spelling. Here around 69, 670 and so on. On page 17, there's a word infuriated. This is a spelling mistake. It should be infuriated. Then on page 48, on the bank of the Ganges near Digby. This is not Digby, it is Delhi. On page 49, there are so many goswamins, but there should be no end. In this way, I have read the book sporadically, not very minutely. I think it should be gone through once more very carefully, and all the mistakes that are still existing there should be corrected. If the books are printed with spelling mistakes and other mistakes, that would be a discredit for our publication. So please see that editorial work is done very nicely. So also notice, Prabhupada said, you know, he hasn't been able to go through, you know, the entire book. He's just opened a few pages and pointed out some things, but he didn't go through all his books very minutely. I mean, he simply didn't have time to do that. Next to Tamakrishna and Gurudas in 71, even if it is 99% all right, still that 1% must be corrected. The Prabhupada, he doesn't want any mistakes. Next, letter to Mandali Bhatra from January 1972. It is not our philosophy to print errors. Of course, our spiritual subject matter is transcendental, and therefore it remains potent despite mistakes in grammar, spelling, etc. But this type of translation may only be allowed if there's no other way to correct it. Then it's all right. But if you know the correct order, then you must make it perfect. That is our philosophy. Everything perfect for Krishna. And there's one more letter to Mandali Bhatra. No, to Hansa Dutta, but it's actually about the German books. It is not that we may present anything crude translation and that is acceptable. No. Even though the transcendental subject matter of Vedic literature is still spiritually potent despite the crudest translation, still because we have got the facility to make it perfect, that is our philosophy. Two letters to Radha Vallabha. Regarding the English editing discrepancies, how can I know? Let them point out which part and on which page so I can see. And regarding the corrections you have sent, these kinds of changes are admissible. There is no harm. And then he writes to Radha Vallabha in 76, concerning the editing of Jayadvaita Prabhu, whatever he does is approved by me. I have confidence in him. Your changes which I have seen of the Sanskrit synonyms is also approved by me.
I have a question in the last letter to Radha Vallabha.
Yeah.
Does that refer, is there any reference to what kind of mistake that was corrected there?
What, regarding the corrections you have sent, these kind of changes are admissible, is that one?
It's the second letter, right, from the 21st of September.
Okay, okay.
So that the changes are
admissible. There is no harm. You probably, you have to go and, I know that it's kept in the archives, the letter that Prabhupada is replying to, that you have to find out what it is.
I don't know. It would be nice, I mean, that would be, I mean, that there is no harm that, that these, what are these kind of changes?
Yeah, I mean,
he's allowing changes in the books.
Yeah, there's no harm.
And there is no harm.
Yeah.
Because he's, what kind of changes are you referring to? Probably
language.
Yeah.
To probably say that the editor should edit for force and clarity. So there should be no mistakes, and then it should be, you know, formulated in a way which is clear and, you know, and powerful and strong, clear and strong language. Yeah, but of course, someone will have to check out precisely what he is referring to here, what kind of changes. But I guess we kind of like an educated guess. You know, changes that does not change the meaning or add or subtract anything, just change, but just better language. Better language is okay. And yeah, then here, the next one to read to you a letter from Rameswara Prabhu to Jayadvaita Swami from actually for a few months back, 18 September 2013. And on that occasion, Rameswara, he sent a letter to Jayadvaita that he had written to Prabhupada in 1977. And not Prabhupada's reply, because that time Prabhupada did not reply letters anymore. Saman Krishna Goswami was the one who was replying the letters. Saman Krishna Goswami would read, he, you know, he was Prabhupada's personal secretary and servant, and actually with Prabhupada 24 hours a day. Prabhupada was very sick at this time, or seemingly sick. And so Saman Krishna Goswami would read the letters to Srila Prabhupada, and then he would write down what Prabhupada replied and send letters to devotees saying that Prabhupada said such and such, and also just tell devotees about what was happening. No, his letters are a mixture of both, you know, eyewitness accounts of what's going on and Prabhupada's direct instructions or in reply to letters. So here Rameswara, he writes, "Dear respected PPT, trusty Prabhus, Hare Krishna, please accept my lowly, humble obeisances, all glories to Srila Prabhupada. I have seen the 1977 Rascal Editor's conversation with Srila Prabhupada misquoted, misused, and presented out of context numerous times, especially by the tireless proponents of no editing. It's often thought incorrectly that this was Srila Prabhupada's final comments on editing before departing from his pastimes in this world." This, of course, refers to a very famous conversation in June 1977, when Prabhupada got very angry that he found there was a mistake in the Bhagavatam reading. And then he got into a conversation about how the rascal editors, they were changing things unauthorizedly and so on. And as Rameswara, he writes here, that conversation is one of the most misquoted, pulled out of context conversations that is circulating in ISKCON. And the actual context is that some months before Prabhupada had discovered that in Easy Journey to Other Planets, the section about that it's not possible to go to the moon had been pulled out. Hayagriva had actually taken that section out because he thought now that actually they've gone to the moon and you know, we cannot have that in our books anymore. And the Prabhupada found out that he got completely furious. And Prabhupada, at this time, that was still on his mind. So he's mainly referring to this kind that the editors actually change his books, you know, really take out things which they think, anyway, this is not, we don't believe that ourselves, and we should not present this to the public. So the conversation is actually, that's kind of the, you know, the background for the conversation. And Prabhupada, he is talking about the rascal editors, and he's mentioning particular names of actually four editors that he is very dissatisfied with. Of course, also one thing I think we have to understand, Prabhupada has the right to be dissatisfied with his editors and call them rascals. I don't think we have that right. All the editors, including Hayagriva, did tremendous work in Prabhupada's books. We do not have books. Prabhupada's books on that level if they had not done that work. But Prabhupada could call them rascals, and we can, you know, of course, we just still pay our obeisance to them. But also understand that there were some mistakes that should not have been made. So Prabhupada, he was talking about and expressing his dissatisfaction with this, that kind of editing, and how there have been so many changes, unnecessary changes in his books. And then they discuss, so what to do about this. And that's one point that they don't notice. But there's actually in that conversation there is a solution given. Sraddhamana Maharaj proposes it, Samakrishna Maharaj repeats that proposal, Prabhupada accepts it. And the proposal is that three editors, Jayadvaita Prabhu, no, he was not Swami at that time, Satsarup Goswami and Bhakti Prem Swami, they should go back to the books, to the original, and bring the books back to the written manuscript before the next print. That is actually, you know, that is actually the conclusion in this rascal editor's conversation. So, yeah, but then here. Ramaswar, he got also, you know, this conversation was also sent to him, and of course he was a chairman on the, you know, the leader of the BBT in North America, and he of course, you know, he wrote back to Prabhupada with great concern. He was explaining a lot of things and asking, and so what precisely do you want in light of this conversation? And so he writes here, on July 13, 1977, I wrote a four-page letter to Tamal Krishna Goswami to read to Srila Prabhupada. In it, I described three broad categories which we felt called for editing. Tamal wrote me back on July 22, 2013, after reading it to Srila Prabhupada. Noteworthy in the response are the following. Your suggestion that in the future any mistakes which are found can be reported to Satsarup Maharaj, Jagadvaita Prabhu, Radhavala Prabhu, or yourself, and after sufficient investigation and conversation and confirmation, these mistakes can be rectified, is accepted. And although he, Srila Prabhupada, has certain doubts in regard to the perfectness of our service, he is quite confident that you will do the needful to make any corrections that are required. I explained the contents of your letter and Satsarup's and Brother Balabhas, and he seemed satisfied that things were not being unauthorizedly changed, while at the same time whatever corrections needed to be done were being made. And Ramaswara, he writes here, a copy of my letter and a copy of response are attached below for your review and use. They are the last instructions I ever received about editing from Srila Prabhupada, and they confirmed that proper editing was to be continued. Clearly, the masses of devotees have not been privy to this, and are exposed to the constant propaganda and incorrect notion that the rascal editor's conversations contains Srila Prabhupada's last comments on editing. I hope this is useful, and pray ardently to remain your eternal aspiring BBT servant, Ramaswara Das. I also have the letter also, Ramaswara's letter, and Prabhupada Tamakrishna Goswami's reply. but I don't have time to read it here now. But it's just that this idea that it's not authorized to change anything after Prabhupada's passing away in his books is not correct. Prabhupada said, in the future we can do like this. That means it can be done authorizedly in the future. And to get practical, I wanted to kind of spend 10 more minutes to give some examples of corrections.
Vi skal slukke snart igen.
Ja, så når jeg...
Der er møde, og der er...
Ja, ja. Okay. Then we can just stop here. We can lay down. Oscar?
First we have to correct the examples before you can give them the...
Is it at... Skal vi med A? Like this?
Yeah. Can I ask one thing? What is like the main argument for against that Srila Prabhupada's book should be
it changed? I mean, I've been pushing for time to figure out what actually are the arguments, and it's unclear to me. Except that, you know, you can repeat that Prabhupada's book should not be changed. There's no disagreement. I mean, I also think that Prabhupada's book should not be changed, but also there should be no mistakes. And correcting mistakes is not changing. And it seems that there's the idea that Prabhupada had sat with Hagrida meticulously, proved of each word and each sentence like that, and nothing should be changed. It cannot be changed because Prabhupada had already been, there. So there's a misunderstanding of how Prabhupada's books were actually written, and the Prabhupada. I've really been trying to understand hard what they're talking about, and I don't get it. I really don't get it.
Some devotees that have this impression that Prabhupada, he had both the books after they have printed and he has been reading them and using them, and then you can find some quote also where Prabhupada says that they shouldn't be changed or anything. But it's, as you said, it's taken out of context.
Things are taken out of context, and
it's this idea that Prabhupada, he was reading the books, but also the example of Prabhupada like sometimes giving a lecture and then he's reading something from the book and then pointing out some mistake, but it's not that he was doing it all the time because that's not what he's... Because this editing is really...
It's a different...
That's a different thing than just reading books. Mm-hmm. And sometimes you can read a book like 10 times and then you're suddenly, oh, there was a mistake there because you're not like looking for it.
Mm-hmm. In most contexts, you're not looking for mistakes, you just want to... absorb the content, the actual reading matter, that's what we want to, discuss the philosophy and so on. But it's also obvious when you look at, if you take the Bhagavad Gita, the mistakes that are there, they're so obvious that it's clear Prabhupada did not prove that there is a planet of the trees is one of the things. It's quite humorous example. I mean that it's a mistake by the one who is listening to dictating the planet of the pit trees, not of the trees. There are some serious mistakes in the Sending 2 edition. There were things pulled out. There were deliberate things that were Hagrida, he took out, but just like he took out this with the moon landing or going to the moon, there are two other places in the Bhagavad Gita where he pulled things out because he did not like them. One is the 10th chapter about that the stars are like moons, they're not separate suns. They're like the moon, the stars also reflect the light of the sun. That paragraph was pulled out in the 72 edition by Herr Grieber. He did not like it. Another place is in 1607. It's Prabhupada, he dictated that once very carefully every day keep himself clean by bathing, brushing teeth, shaving, etc. The shaving was actually removed by Herr Grieber because he had a beard. He likes to have a beard. So there are places that were pulled out, and there are whole paragraphs that somehow they were in the 68 edition, but somehow that disappeared in the 72 edition. In the, for example, in 926, this Patron Pusantam Palam about offering me a leaf of fruit or water. There's a very, very, very transcendental, beautiful, long paragraph. Prabhupada talks about the necessity of being Krishna consciousness, and this is the way how to be. That simply is not in the 72 edition. Somehow or other, I think it's a mistake in the production process. It disappeared. And there's so many simple, obvious mistakes. That is, Prabhupada has not approved these mistakes. You can find that actually. Queen Kunti is speaking in the Upanishad, for example. There's one place like that in 7:25, 7:24, I think it is. Actually, said that she speaks in the Queen Kunti. Queen Kunti is quoted from the Upanishad, and so on. So again. Examples from another time.
But the Pope was right that it was just from the Bhagavatam.
No, it was true. There is a Pope of Queen Kunti from the Bhagavatam. And then there's a slogan in the Upanishad which repeats the same point. But it appears that Queen Kunti is speaking in the Upanishad. It's just
she's speaking
in the Bhagavatam, yeah. And then in the 72 edition there is a reference to a verse in the Bhagavatam. Actually, it's the wrong verse. It's a verse after. So there's examples. It's just the references are just wrong. So it's obvious. I mean, you can see.
Yesterday, in fact, to
return the version. Yeah. So it's obvious. One can just check. That's what editors do. They check. And just wrong, or they just correct.